Hey everyone, today I wanted to show you a waterproofing detail. It's a very common location to get a leak. So when you're building a home, it's really important to do it right. So I wanna show you on a custom home that we're actually building now, what we're doing to make sure that it gets done. So we'll go ahead and get started and we'll show you what we're talking about. All right, so I've stepped back and I want you to see where this condition actually takes place and where you could possibly get this leak if you don't do this properly. So what you're seeing here is this black piece of wood is a piece of fascia that's running over and it's dying into another wall. So we're gonna go ahead and get up close and I wanna show you how this actually needs to get done and what the potential problems could be. All right, so we're up here nice and close so you can kind of see what's going on. So this piece of wood right here, this is a 2x8, and this is your fascia board, and this is running over into the wall here, okay? On the back side, what you can see is you got the tail coming off of your truss that's here, and then you end up having your subfascia back there. So that's to meet fire code. So you'll see that there, and then what you have here is a piece of subseal, it could be Jiffy Seal, it's basically a peeling stick, and you can see that it has the backing on it here. This keeps from sticking to something. So that's right here, okay? This is really, really important. This is what you need to do in order to make this thing, keep this thing from leaking. So a lot of times what will happen is you will see a framer take this fascia, and what they'll do is they'll run it all the way tight to the other side, to the actual wall right here. No, nothing gets put back behind here, okay? And you also see it's like it's tight, you can't get anything behind it as far as putting in any like siding or stucco. So this gap has to be adjusted here if you're putting siding or stucco, because you gotta slide behind this with the material that you're using. So what we've done here is we make sure that we've cut this back. This is probably about a half or 5/8 of an inch that you're seeing here of a gap. And this allows you to get fiber cement siding there because you're gonna have it lapping over itself. So it's 5/16 times two, and you have a little bit of a gap so you can slide that through and get it up in here depending on where the laps actually hit, where the siding laps on this piece. So, but before we put the siding on, this gets on here, this goes on first. This is actually even before, you can see the Z-bar backing, which is this, this is a 1x4 that's sitting here. And this is for flashing for the Z-bar, and I'll show you how that works in a second. But once this goes on first, so you can get it behind this whole section right here, because you don't want this to leak right here. This is where the leak would occur in this area right here. The water would come in and it'd pour down the wall. So what this allows us to do is allows us to get paper back up underneath this. So we can get paper behind this all the way around the back, slide it up under, and we can get paper out in front of this, and then we would remove the piece keeps it from sticking on the back. We pull this off, and then that we'd stick this right, just staple it down to the paper, and now everything's sheeting down. So it's all sheeting down the wall. It goes all the way down, all the way down to the wall to the ground, and it's not going to leak. So even if the water gets behind the siding, it's not going to leak. So what we do here, the way this is set up, and this is to help the roof if they were at the re-roof in the future, you would take and you put the Z-bar backing on here, regardless if you have siding or regardless if you have stucco, you'd put this on here. And then when they, if they're using shingles, they'd have a step flashing that goes here that laps with the shingles that goes up all the way up underneath the eave up there. And then what ends up happening is the Z-bar metal has a piece of metal that comes down. So you see here, it comes down here like this, comes out, and then it counters over the top. This would be on top of this, but it counters over the top of this other metal. So the metal will be on top of this paper. And then then you have paper that goes on top of this Z-bar metal that runs all the way up the wall, up to the top. And then everything is sheeting down. And then this, and even if water gets through here, it hits this and then runs down the paper if it gets behind the siding. But they also will take on this metal they put here, and they put a kick out flashing that ends up kicking out right here, which then pushes the water away from that spot even further. And then if you're putting gutters on, you'll end up having a gutter here that'll slide up underneath this metal here, the drip metal, and then it'll end up dumping right into your gutter and then running out. So really important detail. So to make sure this happens, so make sure you hold this fascia back, get this peel and stick membrane in here before you end up putting any of this on here. So make sure before your Z-bar backing, everything goes on and get it tuned up. All right, well, I hope you learned something about that waterproofing detail where your fascia runs into your wall. If you'd like more information on building a custom home or building an ADU or a whole house remodeling project potentially, feel free to reach out to us. You can go to our website at freemansconstruction.com. Make sure you check out all of our resources on our resources page. We got a ton of floor plans, pricing information. Also got a very comprehensive FAQ page that has a lot of answers to the questions you might have. So, all right, thanks again for watching and have a great rest of your day.